Sometimes that happens to good teams. Great teams never let that happen. Great teams never play flat. Great teams never let something get away that shouldn't because they prepare. I told you last week, you get to 7-0, you'd be a good team. I still think this is a great football team. You haven't done anything to make me think otherwise. You've prepared, you've overcome adversity, you've come from behind, you've worked in the direction to put yourself 7-0. Not with a lot of flash. Not to be, I don't know, some might even say, not with a lot of emotion. Because some people equate emotion to jumping around and screaming and putting their finger in the air. I equate emotion to knowing that I just knocked the living shit out of somebody and someone's looking at me and saying, yep, I'm the hell out of here.
We've run what we've run right along. We run out of the eye primarily. We show multiple formations. This year we thought coming into the year that we had two fine tight ends in Chris Frank and Brian Terleski, and we would be able to show a two tight set more often. That in addition to the fact that we had a number of fine running backs in Sylvester Patton and DeMond Taylor and Pat Grossen, along with three strong fullbacks and Mike Billy, Jason Benson, and Kenyon Meadows, we thought that we'd be able to spread the football around and maintain fresh legs going down the stretch of the season. That combined with the fact that we knew we had an outstanding offensive line coming back that had a lot of experience. We knew that we'd be a run-oriented football team, and that's exactly what we did. We were able to come out and control the line of scrimmage, and we thought that going into every game that our bread and butter would be running the football.
The Cowboys were really strong. Could you tell us about the defense this year?
I think the defense came to age in the Camel game. I think that, you know, going over to Camel and shutting them out and shutting them down actually really provided them with a tremendous amount of confidence. And, you know, they established themselves as an old-fashioned Chaney defensive football team. And, you know, our kids took off on that, and Mike Popio certainly did a great job cultivating that. And, you know, face it, you know, kids like to play defense, and our kids rallied around the defensive flag, and they kept us in every football game and did an outstanding job. Beat!
Popeo, your staff, it seems like you've assembled a heck of a staff there, Chaney. Can you talk a little bit about them?
Oh, absolutely. you know, I feel that we have just a great working relationship in our staff. We have a bunch of guys that are unselfish and are willing to put beyond the required time at it, and you know, our kids know that, and it just makes for a great situation, because we spend a lot of hours together, and it certainly helps when you're friends and you like each other, I've been very fortunate at Chaney to have a certain degree of continuity, and a couple kids that I had the opportunity to coach, you know, have now turned into assistant coaches for me, and all of them do a phenomenal job with, you know, I mentioned Mike Popeo coaching our defense. You know, he certainly does a great job. He's as organized and prepared as any coach I've ever seen. And, our defensive backfield and our wide receivers are coached by Alan Mikovich, a kid, that I coached in the secondary as an assistant under Ed Matey. And he's developing into a fine young coach. Paul Lamangi, my first year at Chaney was his senior year, and he's hooked up with us, and he coaches our offensive line and our defensive line, and for a young guy, it's absolutely unbelievable the job that Paul does, because he's like an old war horse out there. He really does a fine job, and of course, you know, Red Saunders, he's almost established legendary status on the West Side. You know, he's the stabilizing force in the staff. Great experience and great knowledge of the game, and he does a great job for us. Also, a guy that we elevated from the ninth grade program, Steve Zielinski, stepped in to replace Chuck Samarone, and Steve coached our defensive ends and our tight ends, and really just meshed real well with the staff. We're certainly glad to have him, and looking forward to having him around for a long time. And our freshman coaches, Will Bagnola and Bill Miller, you know, they do a great job down there with our ninth grade program. They're with us at all our meetings, and they scout with us, and collectively, I think we got as fine a staff as anybody in the area. We have some people that just volunteer their time. Dennis Bellish comes over and gives us a tremendous amount of time, and the same with Rob Sylvester. We certainly appreciate the fact that those guys want to keep their hand in it, and they were great players at Chaney, and it's great to have them around. Well, I think you have to look to your seniors first and foremost. I think that we had 16 kids that came up through the program and just did an unbelievable job of providing leadership and a tremendous amount of effort and confidence that this team needed. I think that our program has stressed from the very beginning that we want to get this thing turned around, and we want to win, and we want to win humble. I think there's a place for that, and I think our kids believe that also. I think when we were 5-0 and then going into the league play, I think that our kids really were starting to hang their hat on that you could win, and you can win like a man, and you can win with a large degree of modesty. There was no flash involved, and there was no fingers in the air, and there was no towel waving, and there was no "we're number one." I think our kids just approached the every game of the season the same way. You know, it was just work as hard as you can, and go out and play as hard as you can, and let the chips fall where they may. I learned that from a great coach who I think is the greatest coach that I ever knew, Red Angelo. And I tried to pass that along to our kids, and our kids believed it. You know, and when you got great kids, and you got great kids that believe, like we had, things are very easy. It doesn't take a lot of imagination on the sideline, offensively or defensively, when you got great kids. And the bottom line, Chaney was 9-2 this year because we had great kids.